how do you feel that should be announced in making clear that if the performance principles can't act against the system? My other thing is putting commas in where they haven't used commas. I mean, you also sort of use punctuation, use punctuation, use punctuation. There's been no comma use throughout the document before that. And then that taking the decision is urgent. I mean, that just appears out of nowhere. And it doesn't seem to play with that as a good justification, which I think is what it's meant to say. But it seems to imply that the use of the comma that only the mayor's decision has to be better. Instead of making that reasonably fair. So, I mean, in my view, that's why I don't want to do these kind of things.
Thank you.
Sorry, I know that was very technical.
Councillor.
Delegating to the head of legal services the power to change the constitution.
we have it on record.
Save yourself the consultation with members.
No, Chair, what I was trying to suggest is I appreciate there's obviously a number of debates and a number of issues being raised in terms of the, particularly around the access to information regulations, which in fairness and caution are not the easiest well-written regulations, but it's important that members do understand the implications and issues and like every aspect of the Constitution. One suggestion may be that if you are in principle agreeable to the changes, it may be such that the consultation constitution that is issued can reflect those changes. Yes, and I can put all that forward, having regard to your voter representation, so that the constitution that I put forward for your reference, as well as obviously alongside the original version, I can reflect the changes that you are happy to be included, and that could be part of the minor consideration going forward. I'm not sure whether that helps members.
Okay. Can I just say, if we didn't agree this, would the situation be that if a senior officer left and the name of the previous officer, that we couldn't give the director of law the directive to change that name? Is that what we're actually debating? Because I can't believe that as a serious committee, we are sitting here trying to argue the pros and cons of doing that. That is a nonsense. Sorry if it is. And I don't believe that we'll need to make progress tonight, if that's the level of discussion.
No, two things, Chair. First thing is, I'm looking to start this. I was alerted to some issues by Councillor Keane, my colleague, which have made me question this. I personally don't have a particular problem with Pembroke updating names of officers. However, would it not be more prudent, rather than having named officers, to have named postcodes? In which case, then, you know, if Joe Bloggs leaves the position of head of somebody else, Fred Smith is appointed head of, he then becomes a postholder. You don't need a name, you just put it by postholder. Second thing, Chair, in order to try to be even more helpful and to take on board what Councillor Harvey has said, he's quite right. Elected members should be making these decisions and these recommendations. And I would suggest, because clearly we are making any progress, and it is going to be a difficult thing to go through line by line, I think that's necessary, that this again is withdrawn and becomes part of the work of the standards working party to come forward with a set of words that takes forward to full consultation with all elected members during next year that satisfies everybody's needs. I think that is a way forward, Chair.
And
I'm not trying to start with
this. I'm going to amend, make a move and amend now to that recommendation, since we moved away from what I thought before. And I'm going to suggest that the County Committee now accept those parts of the constitution change that this committee can accept, and accept and refer to Council those that have been scheduled to that need to be. And I thought that as an amendment to Council that is to move some progress tonight and change the recommendation I've heard previously after listening to the last discussions that we've had.
Chair, but I want to understand this document, and clearly Councillor McLaughlin just wants to speak over it through his council to make a decision, not this committee. This committee, if you look at its terms of reference, has this under its responsibility, but it appears Councillor McLaughlin wants to absolve this committee of that responsibility and simply send it to council. If that's the case, I see no point in this committee sitting at all, Chair. Now, in the future.
I'm going to buy a glass of wine if you do it.
Now, I'm going to the boiler. So,
what was the last one?
You're showing
me. Let's see if you want to be all this.
I propose,
Chairman, that there's none of us fully understand this.
You talk about the two boxes, Chris.
No, no, I'm talking about the whole thing. Councillor Harney quite helpfully said that, you know, the head of law has come up with these proposals, and it should be elected members come up with these proposals. And I fully agree with that. We have to remember that it's elected members who are responsible to this council, who answer to the people we're here to represent. And I fully agree with that. We do need the assistance of professional officers. I fully agree with that. And we do need the guidance of professional officers. But that should be done in a way where everybody is involved in putting a document such as this together. Not having a document such as this just put before us. We've had no involvement in this at all. And I'm simply suggesting that this item, this whole item 4 on the agenda, be withdrawn and be looked at by a standard working group along with relevant officers in order to come up with wording that can then be put forward to a full consultation for the elected members before proceeding to council.
Okay,
so
amendment is in order to assist the smooth running of this council prior to the full review of the constitution, which will take place in January, that committee accepts those part of the changes to the constitution which is within its power to accept, and accepts the others referred to council instead of the
second. All those against.
Can you have my vote recorded, please?
Yeah.
Can I have a vote recorded? Can I record my view that now my request for leaving the price wasn't in fact answered?
Well, Tom, we can tell me if all those stories are going to be absolutely.
Next up,